This tutorial is just going to show you how to create a decal and then all the different options, what they look like when we actually put them into RailWorks. So we're going to start off RWDecal, and I've already got the form set up the way I want to. So we're going to do this at 150 meters. We're going to use lead station as our example, which is going to make chunks. The camera speed is going to be instant. We're going to use the due north fix, and we've estimated the value there using the estimate button. Hopefully that will be accurate. We're going to create markers for the full decals just in the corner, so for the whole area that we're capturing in the corners. Go to export the blueprints as well, and as we don't need the source files after we've exported it, I'm going to delete those. So all we need to do now is click run. It doesn't give me a warning, so I've created this before, so I'm just going to click yes to say I'm quite happy for it to overwrite the files. As you can see, it's now jumping around Google Earth, capturing the file information. And now it's going to process those decals and split them back up into chunks. And when it's finished, there it goes, it's now exporting them. And it's finished exporting. And there we go, it took 23 seconds to create that decal, which is nearly a 500 meter square decal. So now I'm going to load up RailWorks and we're going to have a look at how they look inside the game. So we've got RailWorks running now, so I'm just going to pin out all the panels and we'll turn on the markers so we can see them. We're going to switch to the object view and we're going to fly to one of our lower left markers. So we're going to navigate down here, we've got the due north lower left. So just click it and select fly. And just pan the camera back a bit and you can see we've got the nice RWDecal marker. And the big advantage of this marker is that it has no base, unlike the RailWorks marker, which is a big gold base. This one doesn't, which makes it much easier to align the decals as you try and put them into the game. So if you go into our miscellaneous objects, which is where all the RWDecals are created, and we scroll down, you can see that we've got the decals here just appearing. So we've got the due north one that I just created, and we've got some other samples that I'm going to show you of the licensed and unlicensed versions at various different altitudes. So we'll start off actually with the an unlicensed one at 1,000 meters. So we'll just click that, and we're just going to now try and line this up to the marker post here just by moving it about. And to get closer, just zoom in there. Just click off to see how it will do. We need a little bit further across. Oops. Sorry, just created a few extra decals there. As you can see now, that's fairly well lined up. So let's go and have a look at how it lines to the top marker. And as you can see, that's not very good at all. And if we fly across over here, that's not worked well either. Now the reason for this is that there's an error with the due north alignment of decals, which is affecting the game. And if you look at those markers, we see we're aligned to the bottom left one, we're not aligned to there, and we're not too far over there, and we're too far over there. What we actually need to do is rotate that decal by a few degrees, and then if we move it up again, and I've done that very, very quickly, but you can see we start to get a better alignment. Now this can be done automatically for you using RWDecal if you know how much to rotate it by. So as you can see, that's the decal created from 1,000 meters, so it's quite blurry and not a lot of detail. Just before we look at the pre-rotated one, we're going to look at the unlicensed one at 150 meters, which will have a lot more detail, but is going to have the bottom half of the decal rendered in black because we generated it using an unlicensed copy. So there's my marker that I want to line up with. My unlicensed decal, 150 meters. As you can see, although the 1,000 meter one was rendered correctly, the 150 meter one wasn't. Okay, but you can see the level of detail that you can get. You can actually see trains in the station and the individual tracks, so it's now going to be rather easy to lay the track for this quite complex area at lead station. Now let's have a look at a licensed version that's also using the due north fix to rotate the decal. So we just get the camera back where I want it. There's my licensed version. Move the decal about, try and get it lined up for us. Just about there, it's not bad, a little bit across. There we go, very quickly, it's not perfect, but it's not bad. If I had a little bit more time on it, it would be better. So that's our licensed decal, and you see the detail's very good. And then finally, we're going to use our one that's had the due north fix applied to it, which will hopefully make it line up to the markers almost perfectly. So let's get the camera positioned right again. move our marker about. There we go, that's looking pretty accurate there. As you can see, that's pretty much spot on there. Flying across this one, again, much, much better there. And finally, over here, we've got a pretty good alignment as well. And again, you can see that because you did a low altitude, the level of detail in this decal is very high. So that's the end of the tutorial, covering how to actually create a decal and then place it in the game, and also the due north fixed, the difference what the due north fix creates, and what happens with licensed and unlicensed versions when you go below 1,000 meters.